bad, look better. Say all the words that I'm supposed to. Bow my head, say amen. You better do. Making every day look like heaven. Like being okay is the way to reach you. But you're not afraid of all the things I feel. So why am I afraid of being real? You want it back, yes. Every mess you were, every side of hell you feel. You want all the help, but no one back when I'm here. And if I was doing it again, you see the beauty.
Grand rising, beautiful soul family. I'm Coach Suzie, and welcome to the Beyond Abuse Podcast, a show about the power and benefits of using self-love and hope to overcome self-doubt, depression, anxiety, and panic attacks resulting from the trauma and abuse of our past. So we are on day 12 of the 21-day meditation experience with Deepak Chopra and Alicia Keys. I really do hope y'all getting some out of this. I hope that whatever I put out, you know, my hope is that whatever I put out, that someone, even if it's just one person, would resonate with what I am saying, you know, because I do this as an outlet for myself, but, you know, and I know a lot of the messages sometimes are for me, but I also know that I'm not alone in this, that there's somebody else that needed to hear it. So let's go ahead and get to it. We're going to go ahead and pull a card. It's probably going to be something that I've been going through. So I definitely know them cards be like Johnny on the spot. So let's go ahead and get started with day 12 of activating the divine feminine, the path to wholeness. Today is all about open to the source of abundance. Yes. Enjoy.
Welcome to day 12 of our meditation journey. Today's theme is open to the source of abundance. Abundance and prosperity are words that immediately bring up money. The vast majority of people measure abundance by their income and bank accounts. Since history began, the world has divided between the haves and the have-nots. Yet, in reality, abundance is a natural quality of life. I think that abundance is absolutely all of ours to have, and it doesn't have anything to do with what you physically have, because I know so many people that physically have a lot of things and are absolutely not abundant. It do not resonate with that sensation of abundance or just really understanding that we all have what we already need, something that's already inside of you. I really do think of this word gratitude when I think of abundance, and a lot of the times we're so focused on what we don't have that we don't often remember what we do have. And that even through the challenges, those things that we do have, or the things we're learning, or the way that we're growing, or the way that we're accessing more abundance in the sense of what's within us, what's growing within us, what's possible within us, is such a powerful thing to have and a powerful thing to be grateful for. I personally have been able to focus more on being more present with the people around me, like really being present. And that ability to have dinner with them at night, you know, is a pretty simple thing. But to me, that's abundance. It will be fascinating to hear what Deepak has to teach us about it. So let's begin.
At the most important level, where life begins, you depend on abundance, no matter whether you feel rich or poor. The energy of abundance is expressed everywhere. Every cell in your body gets everything it needs, food, air, and water, in abundance. Life on Earth would be inconceivable without nature's abundance. So it is peculiar, once you talk about it, that so many people exist in the attitude of lack and scarcity. Most of us, even in prosperous Western countries, are stuck in an awareness of lack. This is expressed in many ways: being anxious about finances, feeling that life isn't bringing enough good things, or simply looking inside and thinking, "I'm not enough." To cut through the complications, think of abundance not as a goal, but as a starting point. If you have the awareness of abundance instead of lack, then you will be fulfilled. Looking inside, you will know without a doubt, "I am enough." Awareness of abundance might bring more money, or it might not. The point is that your attitude or feeling of contentment won't change either way. You will be fulfilled from the inside. Fulfillment is a much better measure of abundance than material success, money, possessions, and so on. It is next to impossible to trust in material abundance. We've all read stories of people who went from rags to riches and then back to rags again. What you can trust is the quality of abundance that comes from the source inside you. The divine feminine is abundance itself. It takes a major shift to trust that abundance is yours. We have to consciously change our attitude. This begins to happen in meditation because the closer you get to your source, the more you can trust in your true self. The obstacles to trust fade away, and you discover that the energy of abundance is always with you. "I am enough" is the bedrock of a life that brings joy and fulfillment. The alternatives are only temporary. As we prepare to meditate together, let's take a moment to consider our centering thought. Nature's abundance is open to me. Nature's abundance is open to me.
Nature's abundance is open to me. Do you know how much abundance there is in nature? Nature's abundance is open to me. It's open to you. You know, and we struggle. We struggle with the fact that we are living abundantly. We are, you know. Nature's abundance is open to you. It's already there. So what are you striving for? What are you competing for? You know, it's already abundantly yours. You just have to step into it. You know, you just have to trust in that inner knowing within you, you know. And, you know, that is living in your divine feminine. And is it easy? No, it's not. You know, trust is a very hard thing. It really and truly is, especially when you've been psychologically abused. You know, so it really does take you strengthening that divine feminine and not allowing other people to manipulate your energy, you know, because you are abundant in nature. And I'm learning that lesson right now, actually. It's another lesson for me. So I'm just like learning that lesson right now, and you know, getting some more things from spirit. And you know, I have pulled that give card and the innocence card, and did what spirit asked me to do, and not focusing on the results, right? Because you don't need to focus on the results. Just do what spirit asked you to do. That's all. Don't worry about how it's going to turn out. Just do what spirit asks you to do, because a lot of times that's strengthening your intuition, that's strengthening your trust in the universe, you know. So don't worry about the outcome. And I think so many of us focus on the outcome that we lose the blessing that's in the abundance. You know, you are abundant. You are a part of nature. You are, it's abundance is in you. You just got to go find it. You got to go tap in. You got to go tap into that divine feminine, you know. Be in that space of the divine feminine. So let's go ahead and pull the action card, and then we'll pull an angel card. But yeah, you got to trust. You got to trust. If you ever desire to have what it is that you desire to have in this world, you got to trust. You definitely got to trust. So let's go ahead and get to that. See what the action card is for us today. See what action do we need to take today? Spirit, what's the action card for us today? And then we'll draw an angel card to get more clarity with the action. Yeah. So I really do hope y'all getting something out of this. I got a lot out of it. Of course, I'm done, but I'm just doing my recordings now, catching up. But this has been a blessed meditation. It really and truly has. It has really changed a lot within me, you know? And remembering, yeah. Remembering. Stop taking things personal. I think that has been my downfall. Yeah. Not taking things personal, you know, it's taking things personally when I shouldn't, you know, realizing that people love you how they love themselves, you know. Realizing that people love you how they love themselves. And you just got to be with people who and respect themselves. And even if someone does not love and respect you, still respect them. Still respect them. Action card today. What is the card? There you go. Okay. So it popped out once and then I put it back and it popped out again. Give. 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 I think that is really what spirit is saying to me right now, because and this is just a transparent moment that I've been toxic in my giving, you know. I've been expecting something in return and I can't, you know. That's not giving. That's not true giving, you know. Giving is just giving from a space of love, whether you receive anything in return or not. That's the true meaning of giving, you know. Give something to somebody, give a compliment or call someone just to let them know you are thinking about them, you know, whatever it is. Yeah, and that was just what spirit was speaking. So if y'all heard me kind of whispering, it's just like, you know, I've been toxic in my giving, you know. I've been expecting people to give me things when they're not obligated to give me anything, you know. And you have to be able to give without expecting anything in return. Do you deserve reciprocation? Absolutely, but maybe the reciprocation won't come from that person. So, just learning and growing on this journey as much as I possibly can, you know, getting out of my own way, letting go of toxic behaviors and things of that nature, you know, growing in my own space, you know. Just doing what I need to do for me. So, you know what it is. All right, spirit guides, guardian angels, archangels, ascended masters, the wisdom of the divine. How are we supposed to give? Give us clarification on that. How are we supposed to give? In what manner are we supposed to give? We thank you in advance for clear and concise messages, for confirmation of how are we supposed to give. Let us give from a space of love and not from a space of neediness. And grateful for Archangel Gabriel's assistance on this journey of and helping me with my communication, guiding me, leading me. Sometimes it gets hard, right? But if it didn't challenge you, it's not going to change you, right? So if it's not challenging, you won't change. How are we supposed to give? What's the message? Thank you in advance. So thankful and grateful. So be it and so it is. I love you. What are we supposed to give? What kind of act of kindness? What kind of gift? What kind of compliment? What kind of, who should we call? Who should we call? Thank you. What should we give as an act of kindness? I guess I should just take them, whatever pops out, huh? Okay. This card is listen. Okay. So give the gift of listening. That's good. I like that spirit. Yes. Give the gift of listening, you know, because not everybody wants advice, right? And it's taken me a long time to realize that everybody, not everybody needs advice. You know, some people just need to be heard, you know, and someone that will listen to them, you know. And the angel literally has her finger up to her lips, like silence. You know, listen and silent are spelled with the same letters, right? So sometimes it's great for us just to be silent and listen to what spirit is telling us, what spirit is saying to us, you know, because spirit is always guiding us. But a lot of times we allow our thoughts and trust issues and past mishaps and mistakes and things of that nature to hinder us, you know, and to cloud our judgment, our instincts, you know, fear, you know, of the past repeating itself is a struggle for many of us. You know, we want to be able to trust somebody, but the past may repeat itself, you know. Life isn't perfect. It's not meant to be, you know. And it's good to quiet the mind, to go within, to listen, to be open to receiving the guidance, the guidance that you're looking for. And trusting what the guidance says, you know. Says, quiet your mind, beloved one, and listen to our gentle reassurance that everything has been taken care of. Stay in a quiet and receptive state without worrying about the exact nature of your desires manifestation. A quiet mind and body hears this quickly and clearly. This is our request to you. Listen. So I've been listening. And then, you know, of course, when things don't go how you think they should go, you're like ready to give up, right? No, you can't. You can't give up. You gotta keep going. Until the manifestation comes, you know. And we've had that card, what do you desire, you know? And do you know your desires don't come just because you desire them, you know? It does take a little bit of work. You know, takes a little bit of trust. Now I got to figure out what I'm going to do if the situation repeats itself. How am I going to handle it? That's my next question to spirit. Let's get the deeper meaning of this. You receive this card because the angels wish to get their messages through to you. They ask that you talk less and listen more. When we're stressed, we tend to chatter out of nervousness. Give your worries to the angels and trust that they've heard your prayers. If it seems they're not answering your prayers, it's probably because you're not listening to their answers. So retreat to a quiet place with the intention of listening to your angels. Then close your eyes, breathe deeply, and listen. Avoid noisy environments. You've been hearing your angels correctly. Turn off the television or radio. Your hearing is becoming more sensitive because you've been tuning into the angels. Clear your ear chakras by visualizing light clearing the area above each eyebrow. I just said, too, when I do my meditation, I want to change to a different stone. I've been using azurite, but I want to use lapis lazuli because they say that that is supposed to open up the third eye more, and that's clairvoyance. Although I did get a vision this morning, so I don't know what that vision was about, you know. A lot of the times it can sometimes seem confusing, but spirit really is guiding you. So just know that spirit is guiding you, and just go ahead and trust. Just trust, you know. Even if it doesn't work out how you wanted it to, just trust, because know that spirit has something greater for you. And in this place that I'm in right now, it's like it doesn't matter anymore. It no longer matters. So, and being okay with that, you know? Being okay with that. So, that's all I got for y'all today. If you enjoyed the topic today, I hope y'all really getting something out of this divine feminine. I am, you know, it's helped me to dig deeper and to just, you know, get in tune. You know, what was that other card about truth? Like being honest with myself, you know, I think you have to really be honest with yourself about what it is that you want from your life, you know? You got to get honest with yourself. So if you enjoyed the topic today, I invite you to subscribe to my monthly self-care newsletter where I provide tips, tools, and resources on loving yourself deeper every day. Once subscribed, you will receive my free ebook, From Victim to Victor, How to Live an Empowered Life Beyond Abuse. The ebook was created to move you from victim to victor and help you live an empowered life beyond the abuse and depression of your past. It was created to push you and assist you with redirecting yourself toward a more peaceful, happier existence. All subscribers receive 25% off the 5 poetry book bundle, 15% off all products, and free access to the private Facebook ebook support community, From Victim to Victor, How to Live an Empowered Life Beyond Depression and Abuse. There's daily encouragement, weekly challenges, and weekly live Zoom trainings or meetings with Q&A every Friday at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. You can subscribe to the newsletter by copying the link in the description box below or by visiting suziesuttles.com. A special shout out of love and thank you goes to all my YouTube subscribers, podcast subscribers, and podcast listener supporters. I thank you for your love, kindness, and generosity. It is greatly appreciated. When you make a monthly love offering in support of this podcast, it helps to sustain future episodes, and it assists the mission of A Mother's Touch, Inc., which is to provide co-parents and families with love, nurturing, guidance, and the resources they need to become a healthier, happier, more holistic version of themselves. We also assist men and women financially who are leaving domestic violence relationships and struggling financially. You know, what I've learned about this self-love healing journey is the more that I love myself, the more that I become a healthier, happier, and holistic version of me, I raise a healthy, happy, holistic child. And I want to give back to anyone who's leaving a domestic violence situation. You know, I've been there. I know what it's like to struggle, you know, to not have that second income, to need the assistance because I didn't have a lot of assistance. You know, there was a great organization here that paid my light bill twice, I think, but, you know, I've been evicted. I've lived homeless, you know. So I just want to give back because I know the struggle. And that's my whole purpose, and everything that I do is everything that I learned. It taught me something great, and I just want to give that back and help others to become their best self. So the healthiest, happiest, and most holistic version of themselves. So If this is your first time listening to the podcast on Anchor, Apple, Breaker, Google Podcasts, Pocket Casts, Radio Public, Spotify, or YouTube, I invite you, I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for stumbling upon my podcast and upon my YouTube channel. And I invite you to become a podcast, a subscribe to the podcast on YouTube and on the platforms, and to become a listener supporter, because all support is greatly appreciated, whether you're a subscriber on my YouTube channel, the podcast, or whether you are a listener supporter, it is greatly appreciated. So thank you. If you or someone you know is in need of financial assistance, please fill out the form for financial assistance via the web at www.amotherstouchinc.org. You can also make a love offering donation via the website, or you can do that on Cash App, which is $A Mother's Touch Inc, or Venmo, which is the @ A Mother's Touch Inc. That's all I got for y'all today. I love y'all and I thank y'all for joining me. But you know, before I let you go, I have to send you out with a prayer of love to the universe. So let's go ahead and do that. Dear universe, I love you and I thank you. This life is all about growth, isn't it? It's all about growth and learning and listening. Listening to that still small voice, and knowing that that still small voice will never lead us in the wrong direction. That we can trust it above everything else, and even if it doesn't turn out like we anticipated or expected, at least we took that time, we stepped out there, right? Because who knows? Maybe I needed to write that. Maybe I needed to say that for somebody else who's listening, who's viewing it. You just never know what will happen from that situation. So I trust you. I'm listening. As that card said, I'm listening now more than ever, because I want to go in the right direction. I want to give like I used to. I gave without thinking, without wondering what was I going to get back. And I lived a blessed life. I mean, I'm already, well, I don't want to say blessed. I lived an abundant life. And I'm not talking about monetary abundance. I'm talking about the richness of my soul. And I read that poem last night, and it's a reminder that I'm just here to pour. That's all. I'm here to pour. And you know exactly what I need. And I know that you will take care of those needs, because you've been taking care of me. And you gave me this light and this love for a reason. It's not for me to hide it, but it's for me to give it. Give it because I know where to tap in and fill up. I'm not in need anymore. I'm not needing somebody to love me. I'm not needing somebody to take care of me. I'm not needing somebody to accept me or approve of me. I'm doing it because that's what I've been called to do. And I love you and I thank you. I thank you for continuing to correct me and teach me. And I know that even with the people in my community, I will continue to grow with them. But as I'm growing, they're growing. As I'm learning, they're learning. And I think that that is how it's supposed to be. So I'm thankful and grateful for your love, your teachings, your guidance, your wisdom. I know it's all within me that I am abundant in nature. I am. Nature is abundance, and I am abundant too. It is a privilege and an honor to serve in this capacity. I thank you for being my security, my safety, my strength. You're who I depend on. I don't depend on anything else. And I know that I'm not in competition with anyone because no one can compete with me. I ride my own wave and I stay in my own lane. I do my own thing and I'm no one's competition. If they view me as competition, then that's something that they have to deal with it within themselves. So it's a privilege and an honor to serve in this capacity, in this light. I love you. I thank you. It's a privilege and an honor to see another day. Let's rock this day out. Let's get her done. And so be it. And so it is. I thank y'all. I love y'all so very much. I appreciate y'all for joining me on the podcast. I want y'all to go out. Have an awesome, amazing, and beautiful day today. From my heart to yours, as always. Namaste. Oh, and don't forget to watch or listen to the next video.